Today, I'll be teaching as to how to do a confirmatory factor analysis using AMOS. Before that, we'll be doing the factor analysis via SPSS. This factor analysis has already been uploaded in my earlier video. You can just go through. As of now, I'll be scrolling over it. Go to Analyze, scroll down to Dimension Reduction. From there, move on to Factor. Select all the variables with the help of Shift key, place it in the variables. Now for rotation, click Varimax. You can choose any one of the rotation, it is not an issue, and click Continue. For options, click Sorted by Size, click Suppress Small Coefficients, and regarding the absolute value, I want all those coefficients which are above 0.5. And later click Continue, give a OK. You have to check for your commonalities. See, the extraction should be above 0.5. In the case of LOA3, the extraction is 0.22, so you have to remove this variable so that your model will be fit in the long. Just go to Analyze. Scroll down again back to Dimension Reduction. From there, click Factor. You are removing LOA3 and then click OK. So you can see all the extraction is above 0.5. So there's nothing to worry. Just scroll down. You'll find your rotated component matrix. You can click and then with the help of right tab, copy it. Later, go to Analyze, scroll down to IBM SPSS AMOS. So the screen appears. So first you have to go to the plugins. From there, go on to Pattern Matrix Model Builder. In my previous video, I taught as to how to copy the plugins from James Gaskin's website. So I have downloaded Pattern Matrix Model Builder, Model Fit and Master Validity. So I am just clicking the Pattern Matrix Model Builder as of now, and the screen appears, that is Pattern Matrix Input, where I am going to paste the rotated component matrix. So it has been pasted. Later, click Create Diagram. So the diagram appears. These are the covariances. These are the regression paths. This is latent variable. This is observed variable. This is the error term. And this is the regression weight. Now you can name this variable by giving a click. You have to give double click. So you can name it as LOA. And close it, give a double click, name it as EF and close it, and give a double click, name it as ST and close it. Now the diagram has been set right. Now you have to save the path. You have to save the, without saving you can't just move on. So I am saving it as say www, just you can give any name, there's no issues regarding that. Later, go to Analysis Properties, there move on to Output, click Standardize Estimates, Squared Multiple Correlation, Modification Indices. So here the threshold which I am keeping it as 25, anything below 25 is tolerable. But not above 25, which has to be taken care or else the model fit will be in trouble. Now we are closing it. Now later we are going to calculate the estimates. So the estimates gets calculated. To know the output, you have to click View the Output Path Diagram. Just give a click over here. You have got now the unstandardized estimates. But we require the standardized estimates. So the Sanders estimates appear on the screen. These are the covariances. Now these are the standardized regression weights. These are the squared loadings. Now we have to find out whether this model is fit or not. Again, you are getting back to plugins. So you are clicking master validity over here. So the answer appears. So based on model validity measures, you can just see there is no validity concerns here, and it has been, this particular plugin has been taken from this website, and you can see as of now I don't have any validity concern. This will be interpreted in the later part. You just see alone, that's enough. I am just minimizing it, and later I am going to plugins. I am just clicking model fit measures. So under model fit measures, Cmin/DF is terrible. It is not acceptable. So the suggestion provided is that I have to remove EF2. So this is the cutoff criteria over here. And again, I have taken this plugins from this website. So for me, EF2 is creating a problem, but I am no way interested in removing EF2. I am minimizing it because only there will be one variable left over. So for that, I will be just going to view text. First, in the case of notes for model, the chi-square value is 190.339. The DF is 24 and P level shows it is significant because it is less than 0.05. Then I am moving on to my modification indices. Now under modification indices, you see that if I covariate error term 3 with E4, I can reduce the discrepancies up to 73.721. To understand the interpretation of this, just give a click over the value. See, you will get the interpretation. If you repeat the analysis treating the covariance between E3 and E4 as a free parameter, the discrepancy will fall by at least 73.721. Again, you can see it is E3, E5 has to be covariated because it is 36.868. Here also you can give a click on the value, you will get the answer for it. Sorry, you can get the interpretation for it. Again, E4 and E5. So we'll be doing all these three. Now with regard to E2 and E5, we can ignore it. It is lesser, so we can ignore it. Now I am minimizing it and I am getting back to covariate E3, E4 and E5. So for that, first I have to click the input path diagram and then I have to select the draw covariances, that is a double headed arrow. So after after clicking it, I have to draw from the below, that is E5 to E4, done, E5 to E3, done, and E4 to E3. Okay, fine. So the covariances has been done. Now I have to leave the covariance, the double headed arrow, back to it its place. So I am just giving a click over it, so you won't get the diagram over it. And later I have to calculate the estimates, and later I have to click the output path diagram. So my values, standardized estimate values, has been appeared. Now again we have to go to plugins. I have to check for model fit because master validity has already told that there's no validity issues. It is only the model fit. So I'm just clicking over model fit. The answer appears. So you find that in the earlier part it was terrible. Cmin/DF was terrible. But now it has become excellent after the covariation of say E3 with E4, E3 with E5 and E4 and E5. This again I have taken from James Gaskin's website. Now this is the cutoff criteria. So as of now I don't have a validity issue and my model fit is excellent. Now later we have to go for the interpretation of the analysis. For that I am getting back to the output. The output appears for me, so I am getting back to the estimates. So you first, you in your thesis, see that you are explaining the regression weights, your standardized regression weights. If you want, you can interpret covariance and correlation, but it is left to you. But you have to interpret the squared multiple correlation. Now for the interpretation of these values, it is not a big deal. Here also, again, if you just give a click over it, you can get the interpretation. When LOA goes up by 1, LOA5 goes up by 0.995. So this is how you can get the interpretation. SE refers to standard error, CR refers to critical ratio, P is the probability value. When you have got a critical ratio, see that it is above 1.96, then only it will be significant. For everything you can give a click, you would get the answer for that particular value. So there's nothing great in interpreting this particular part. Now we have to go to the model fit. So the model fit appears over here. I have written it in a Word format so it become easy for you all to understand as to what has to be put up in the thesis. So we'll just go from the beginning. First the diagram part. So the notes of the model, the chi-square should be significant, that I have already discussed. The modification indices, that the threshold should be decided, but it is left to the researcher to decide. Only when you covariate, your model will become fit. And as usual, you have to explain your regression weights, standard regression weights, correlation and squared loadings. As earlier told, SE refers to standard error, CR is critical ratio. CR should exceed 1.96 to be significant. After placing the diagram in your Word file, you have to explain the diagram, but the explanation of this is already done in your standardized regression weights. But still, for the below the diagram, just write the minimum regression weight, that is minimum standardized regression weight and maximum standardized weight for this latent variable. That is, say for example, for LOA1 it is from 0.97 to 1. And the squared loading also is between 0.94, the minimum and maximum is 1. Similarly, do for EF and ST also. And later write the covariance, that is, it is between 0.19 to 0.37. So even you can report your squared loadings also. So with that, you can end up this explanation here, and we'll just move on to the model fit. So model fit, I have brought the diagram. Sorry, I have brought put up in a table format. See, assessing overall measurement model fitness, the statistic measurement, absolute fit measurement, where you got RM, SEA, GFI, AGFI, Seaman, oblique DF, then incremental fit measurement, parsimonious fit measurement, and then you have to write the test standard value, what is your result, and later what is the final verdict for the result, that is it fit or not. Now you have to report. I'll just be doing one alone. The case of RMSEA is 0.035, a value less than 0.08, stressing on the absolute fit of the model. The case of GFI, it is 0.986, which is above 0.9. The AGFI is 0.969, a value above 0.9. And the last one, that is CM bar DF, is 1.614, which emphasizes a good fit. Now, in the case of PGFI, if the value should be greater than 0.5, but the value got is 0.46, it is anyhow close to the fit, so it is a close approximate fit. So there is nothing to worry, you can carry on with your analysis. Now, next part is your reliability and validity of the model. The validity of the model, which we already had seen with the help of the plugins, James Gaskins plugins, where you could see the validity. Now we are going just for the explanation here. The composite reliability should be greater than 0.7. Yes, it is greater than 0.7. Next, conversion validity also should be greater than 0.5. That is also there. Then for discriminant validity, this maximum shared variance should be greater than AVE. So there is nothing to worry. In the case of maximum R, it should be greater than 8. But in the case of security and trust, it is less. But however, you can carry on with your analysis. There is nothing to worry. Only when there is a big difference, it should be taken care of. Now, to test the discriminant validity, the square root of the AVE was compared to all inter-construct correlation. Then the square root of AVE, which is shown on the diagonals, is greater than the rest of the inter-construct correlation. The diagonal values are 0.98, 0.81, 0.76. Now here shows the correlation between the factors LOA, EF and ST. The above stated aspects met the reliability, thereby making the model fit. So in general, our model is fit. The next is how to save the output path, that is the SEM output path, in a Word file. We'll just get back to the main screen so that we can see, get it. Now the values have disappeared. There's nothing to worry. You can get the values over here by just clicking the output path. But your diagram should be within the white screen over here. If it is outside, you won't be able to copy the diagram. For that, what you have to do is again click the input path here. Here you have got a hand symbol that shows that select all objects. So all objects has been selected. With the help of move objects, it is in the form of a vehicle. You click the move objects, take it along with you. I feel you have to give a double click. So if a single click is enough, I suppose you can just try over. So I brought the diagram from here to here. So I have moved the diagram, and later I have to place the object in that particular place itself. Later you have to click calculate estimates and then run the output path diagram. So you have got it. Now click the or place the cursor on the white screen and click both Ctrl C. After doing that, take your Word file, paste it over here, Ctrl V. So the diagram appears on the Word file. This is how you have to paste your output path in a Word file. Hope you have understood this. Thank you for listening.